Hello, my name is Scott for SB Gaming, and welcome back to American Truck Simulator. In the last episode, we discovered, once again, a new city with Eureka. We went from Winnemucca to Eureka, delivering hay for a profit of $7,593. It wasn't the highest paying job we could have taken. I really wanted that $22,000, but we did get to Eureka. We also got to, where is it we are right now? This is one of the vineyards you have to deliver to. The other one, yeah, right here, San Rafael. And the last one is all the way down here, just outside of Carlsbad. I'd driven past this, I think it was when I went from Las Vegas, down this way. Did I go all the way down to San Diego, or did I just go to Carl's? No, I went that way down to San Diego, that's right. When I did one of these deliveries, I think to here. Anyway, it doesn't really matter. What we are going to do today, we are going to come from Darshell Uzai. We are going to drive over to here, or possibly here. Take a rest, it all depends. And then we're gonna hop out here, and what I'm going to do, I'm gonna just drive into the Walbert parking lot just to unlock this. We're gonna come across here, and I will just drive like this up here, turn around, come back here. The delivery we're taking is, I think, from the Voltison, and then I'll come out here. We'll get all these roads explored so I never have to come back to Eureka ever again. Anyway, coming from Eureka, we have cars. It pays the most, $24.45 per mile. It is an important delivery plus a fragile delivery. It goes to Oakland shippers, so I'll be able to get the achievement for delivering to the two ports. So yeah, about that. We are going to set that as a GPS destination. And next rest stop in 57 minutes. Oh, cop. Yeah, I see you. Your buddy there gave me a $1,300 ticket for running a red light, although it was yellow at the time. I hit the point of no return. I couldn't make it. It wasn't my fault. Police and their profit generation. Anyway, 36 minutes. Yeah, 35 minutes until we get there. Now I'm going to want to bother. Take a rest soon. Which we can right there if we want to. But I'm going to just go into the hotel. That is further down the road for reasons. And we got 40 XP for our another 100 miles of free roam. That's one of these again. And we are going to park just over here. And we are going to stop the engine and take a rest. Income, $453 from Yuri W. And $939 from Wilma F. that is nice to see. We're up to $25,528. And we are going left. Alright, so how far in do I have to drive in order to... Right. Oh. Right there. There we go. Albert has been discovered. Now, one thing I can do is I can take a right here. It really doesn't matter, although with that said, let's take a right. Because of traffic lights. You're working late, guys. 1 o'clock in the morning. Up to the HMS. Really, this is a 30 mile an hour road. Hopefully there's no cops along here. And we have a highway over here. Oh, bother. I missed the entrance point. Although I have a feeling if I didn't, I would have had to go back and explore that little piece of road. We still need to do that in Las Vegas, right near our garage. Speed limit. Okay, that's really odd. This should be 55. Unless it's only 30 for trucks, which makes no sense whatsoever. Might have to report that as a bug. This road from Eureka to the HMS, it says it's a 55, but it's only 30. And we are going to go right. To unlock the rest of Eureka. Seriously? Alright. We're down to 24,608. That's really annoying. I'd really be interested to know what it would take to mod in reasonable speeding tickets. Just overhaul the speeding tickets completely. Let's go. Something a little bit more reasonable. $960 for a speeding ticket. That's just insane. I've explained why the speeding tickets are that high. It's a completely game-related thing. Although the thing I like the most, or rather hate the most about it, is the fact that the cops don't actually need to pull you over. They don't actually need to chase you. They just put their lights on and you get your ticket. Back in 18 Wheels of Steel, you can actually outrun the cops. Oh, I did that often. Cars from Eureka to Oakland, California. $11,756. We're delivering a fragile cargo plus an important delivery. And now... oh, there's a road out that way. Really, guys? You're either at work or you're here to buy a truck car this early. And let's attach the trailer. And now what I would like to do, there's that small piece of road. This way that we're gonna discover. And now what I'd like to do is plot a path going that way. Hopefully this will be explored. All right, so Eureka, once I leave here, I'll never have to come back to, which is good. Oh, interesting. So I was planning to take this route to explore that road, although with that said, there are these pieces of the interstate which I would like to explore, like that piece, that piece, that piece. Yeah, this here as well. So I am going to take Interstate 5. I'm not going to bother stopping through Sacramento, although if I had time I could come this way. Nah, and I still have that little piece of road that I need to explore. That's really frustrating. And then right here to Oakland Shippers, and I'm not going to go this way just because reasons. This is a freaking tight corner. And apparently there's a rest stop there. That's rather interesting. Estimated time of arrival. Trip time is 12 hours, 36 minutes. 484 miles. That's okay. Let's take a left and get out of this hellhole. All right. To the interstate, the highway, whatever this is, and leave Eureka for good. To take a rest stop in 13 hours, so actually we'll get there before we need to take a rest break. And what we could do is just take a rest break at Oakland Shippers. That is a definite possibility. So we are going to want to take a right, and that has been explored. We don't really have an option otherwise. And now the fun begins. is 55 miles per hour. Although I have the feeling the speed limit will change coming up very soon. It is 2:27 a.m. and yeah, there we go, 30 miles per hour. Yeah, let's get up. The sign said 55 miles per hour. Maybe they just kept this road at 30 miles per hour. Now it's at 35 miles per hour. Just not to mess up players. It's like, oh, it's now 55. Now, oh, it's 30. Just keep it at 30. Make it easier for players. Still a lot to accomplish in this game. I still haven't decided when I'm going to be taking a break. Sometime coming up in April, especially if the DLC for Arizona won't be coming out until May, which that's its currently expected date. Although it'd be really nice if it was April. I really hoped it would have been March. You can't do too much about that. Just under 400 miles to go. Estimated time arrival will be about 1:50 in the afternoon, although we know for a fact that's not going to be true, and I want to slow down just because reasons. Called speeding tickets. They are a thing. Yes, indeed. They're a thing given by police. They are a thing I want to mod. Oh, I still want to mod. It's not enough that they scaled the speed limits. The speeding tickets and the other traffic fines. I assume it's the other traffic fines. It's not enough that they scale them to your level. Just because at the higher levels, the traffic tickets are insane regardless. And oh, we're in a 35 zone. Now we're in a 25 zone. And we are in a tight, windy zone. Oh. Yep, I'm never coming back to Eureka ever again. They'd have to pay me $100,000 to drive from Reading to Eureka. Yeah, about that. And we're back to 40 miles per hour. Let's slow down once again. For some reason, it was a lot easier to drive going to Eureka than it was coming from Eureka. And we're up to 55 miles per hour. cruise control on so I can focus on driving rather than my current speed. And I think we are out of the worst of it. Oh, yes, indeed. We're coming back to Reading. Eight hours, 21 minutes to go. Estimated time arrival will be about 1:34-ish. And Reading city limits. Slow down. Slow down a bit more. Even more. And slow down completely because we have a red light. Now, do I want to take that way? No, no, no. I'll save it on my way back up to Reading to go in that direction. Alright, so the places I've completely explored where I never have to go back to is Jackpot. We've explored completely Eureka. And I don't think there's anywhere else. Most of San Diego. Yeah, San Diego. Most of San Diego has been explored. We don't have to worry about it. There's just a little bit we still need to drive on. Oh, I hate the traffic. Come on, truck. Hill starts are bad. The AI is too passive in this game. Here we go. Go, 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 go. Come on. And especially for an on-ramp like this, like, you're on a freaking hill. Seriously, you're gonna let me in? Do not want to have to stop on that incline. That's the last thing you want to do. But if there is a lot of traffic, then yeah. Did I see? Oh. 29 gallons. First off, okay, we can't stop there for gas. Oh, this could be interesting. Oh no. I'm gonna have to get to here. How many miles? 285 overall. This is about halfway, maybe. Here to here. We can go 135 miles. Actually, it would be close. The alternative is there is no alternative. Turning back, jumping off here, coming back up here to get gas. That's the only alternative. Let's do it. Let's do it, do it. And let's slow down to 55 miles per hour. We're going to hope and pray that we can make it to the gas station in time. really the only other option would have been to go to the gas station in Reading or get it back in Eureka. There's a biplane. Miles to go. Where are we right now? It's going to be tight. We're either going to run out of gas close to the gas station, or we are just going to make it with a gallon or two remaining. What I'm going to do is getting to this lane. Miles to go. I might put money on we'll make it in time, but it's going to be incredibly tight. Wow. Oh, this lane ends. Come on. I have a feeling we're not going to make it. Miles, 19 miles. It is going to be close. Six miles to go. Oh my God. Truck came to us. No. Call assistance. $675. I have a feeling if we didn't get pulled over for the weigh-in, we would have made it. We would have made it. Oh, that's frustrating. Trip time, 2 hours, 41 minutes. Remains 5 hours, 39 minutes. Next rest stop in... All right, we'll have about an hour of that we can drive, so... If we are here, we might as well explore just a bit. I'll go this way. Oh, that's frustrating. No, I want to go here, and then I want to go... Yeah, I want to go here, around like that, down like that. Over to here. That's fine. And we have... We can drive about, 280-something miles. We have 60 gallons of gas, 285 miles. Oh, that was... And it cost us $675, that, for a freaking tow. No, like, really, they... They didn't have to tow me to Sacramento. They could have towed me. They could have towed me the 100 feet it would have taken to fuel up. I was right there. And what's annoying is that your truck does not coast. It basically dies and stops where it is. That's frustrating. That's frustrating. And I did not plan to run that low on gas. There's actually very few gas stations up in this area. There's plenty of rest stops, not much in the way of gas stations. Driving 100 miles. We'll have enough gas to get to where we need to go. And what I'm going to do is, yep, go in there. Unlock that. Now, I don't want to pull in there to unlock that, so I'm going to not... If this had been real life, what I would have done, rather than call for a tow, is to basically grab a jerry can and basically walk to the pumps, get about, a couple gallons in the jerry can, and yeah. And then filled up the truck and then drove the truck over to the gas pumps. That was frustrating. Oh, $675 for a tow. I can see if you're, you know, out in the middle of nowhere. All right, we've explored that hotel. You're in the middle of nowhere, yet you're going to need a tow. There's not really a way to plan whether or not you'll make it. And I really, really don't want to... fill up every chance I get. I'm really hoping soon for a 400-gallon tank, maybe? When's the next chassis come available? And let's get back onto the highway. Alright, so the question is, I did discover that. There was nothing else to discover. I've discovered that, so that's nice. Let's get back on, and, about that. It's basically straight down the Highway 5, and then over to Oakland Shippers. Loan installments, $69.95. How much is this one? Oh, $11,756. All right, well, we'll have $30,000 in the bank once we're done this. Well, almost $31,000. That's beside the point. So we're gonna want to slow down and the cruise control on. To 55, ideally. There we go. Passing through Stockton. Yeah, at the very least, my truck should have just coasted. I was banking on that. I was like, okay, if I run out of gas, maybe the truck will coast. Although, I guess, if we are carrying, 20,000 pounds of... Actually, no. 20,000 pounds of cars. That weight would have... That momentum, you know, all that weight behind me, would have kept me rolling, at least. So that is the second time I've run out of gas in this game. First time was way back when. I remember checking the stats on that video when I posted it, and I got one dislike on that video. I'm like, what? Really? Someone disliked the video. I was like, did they dislike the fact that I complained about running out of gas? Is that it? They disliked the video. That's a new thing. I've had a few dislikes on some of the videos. Mostly it's been positive. And 1 hour 29 minutes. We'll be there in 31 minutes, so that's no problem at all. Come on, car. And there we go. Alright, note to self, make sure to get gas. We'll be good for gas. getting to here, but have to stop eventually. And 55 miles per hour. All right. Yes, I know. I know. Slow down. Gonna be taking a right. Actually, what I can do is I can go to that gas station over there. Here. So where do you want it? Alright, so 90 XP, where do you need it? It is going to be off in that direction. Let's play it safe. It's going to be down that way. Rest stop is right there. Nope, we're going to do that one. Yep, I know. So we could just park it there if we wanted to. But no, we want to go with more challenging of drop-off points. Because we are like that. We are parking it where? Let's look out. Relatively easy, just because we have a lot of room to line up the truck. No problem. Although, keeping the trailer straight, a little bit harder than, perk. And cargo is ready for unloading. Let's detach the trailer. And cars delivered from Eureka to Oakland. Achievement progress. I think I like it. 30 of 50 and whatever that was. So we delivered, what, 30 cargo? Is that it? Driven distance, 446 miles. Time taken, 12 hours, 42 minutes. Fuel consumed, 93.6 gallons. For a total of $11,756, 691 experience. Nice. So we got 360 XP for 446 miles. 90 experience, 79 experience, 72 experience, and 90 experience for, yeah. So we just need 235 experience to get up to level 10. That's nice. If we go to new upgrades, we have front rims, rear rims, we have transmission, Eaton Fuller 18 speed, door handles, and divided paint. And it's pretty much going to be the exact same thing, except the Kenworth gets mud flaps on the W900. Okay, look at that. Paint divided on the W900 versus the T680. All right, about that. Well, right now, what I would like to do, we are here right now, and so I'm gonna pop over here, get gas, and we are going to want to take a rest because 41 minutes. We're good. We're good right now. Let's hop back in, and I just want to check to see what's coming out of Oakland. Bakersfield, Carson City, and Truckee. Well, with that said, we haven't actually been to the Walbert, have we? No, we haven't. This is the Walbert. We haven't been to the Bitumen either. And I would like to unlock those, discover those while I'm at it. Freight market. What is coming from Oakland? These are all coming from Oakland shippers, so yeah, about that. I'm going to want to pick them up here. Really, is there nothing else in Oakland? Yeah, there's a gallon here. There's a gallon here. Other than that, these do not generate any actual deliveries. It's only Oakland shippers. So, yeah, about that. So, we won't ever be coming back to Oakland shippers ever again because they don't pay. Anyway, at this point, I'm going to take a break here. I'm going to have to take a look at these to figure out exactly what I want to do. Carson City, no, I don't want to do that for 8,000. No. We have deliveries worth 16,000. 20,000. Like, hazard class deliveries. Things that I've been... Yeah, a lot of these are freaking hazard class. All these high-paying jobs. I need to get back to doing them. Anyway, at this point, I'm going to take a break here, and in the next episode, we'll figure out what we want to do. But thank you for joining me for this episode of American Truck Simulator. Thank you for watching. My name is Scott for SB Gaming, and as always, have a good day.